Braking means to apply friction, lots of it. And for braking, it's vital to distinguish between two different regimes of friction, static friction and kinetic friction. If this object is at rest with respect to that surface, we can apply forces up to a certain threshold force without setting this object in motion. It remains static. Experiments show that this threshold of force is a constant times the weight force, which often is called N because it's a normal force, is perpendicular to the surface. This coefficient is called the coefficient of static friction, mu s. As long as the force that we apply doesn't exceed this force, this object won't be set in motion. When this force becomes larger than the threshold, the object will be set in motion. For example, if the mass of this object is 1 kilogram, the gravitational force would be almost 10 newtons. A pretty high value for this coefficient of static friction would be 1, which means that the threshold force is at 1 times 10 newtons. We would have to exert a force of 10 newtons or more to set this object in motion. If we apply less, it remains static. Typically, this coefficient of static friction ranges between 1/3 and 1, which means that typically, to set an object in motion, you need to apply less force sideways than the force with which gravity pulls that object down. Things are easier in the kinetic regime. We need to apply a certain force to keep this object going at a constant velocity. So this force is nothing else but the force exerted by friction. And from experiments, we find that this force is some constant times the normal force, the force exerted by gravity in this case. And this is the coefficient for kinetic friction. And in the kinetic regime, we got the same expression, but it's an equal sign. In this case, it's not a threshold. We compute the force as such. What's of eminent importance for braking is that the coefficient of static friction tends to be larger than the coefficient of kinetic friction. The coefficient of kinetic friction may be 1/4 less than the coefficient of static friction, or it may even be smaller. And now think about braking. We want to apply the maximum amount of friction. The maximum amount of friction is found in the static regime because the coefficient of static friction is higher than the coefficient of kinetic friction. So what we need to prevent is the locking of wheels. When the wheel stays locked, it's sliding on the ground, and we're in the regime of kinetic friction.